My name is Dr. Eugene Tears, and for nearly 50 years, I have been paying taxes, and I deeply resent people in the super committee calling it an entitlement. I paid for this, and so have millions of others. And I think it's about time that we start balancing the load with everybody in the country and not the middle class and the poor. Listen up, Super Committee.
Hello, Super Committee. I'm Mary Margaret Flynn. I'm a veteran of the United States Army. I am a physician that works for a county. We need single-party payer. We don't need physicians for health care for all arrested as they were at Senator Baucus's Finance Committee. Please reform the tax system. We have the lowest tax rate. We have the poorest medical care. We are becoming a third world country, as one of the other speakers said. We are watching you. There are too many people dying every day because of lack of access to health care, and I see them. It is very sad.
My name is Linda Thomas. I'm a recently retired PR professional with a college education. Ladies and gentlemen, I implore you, find the statesman within you, that person who has the courage to transcend partisan politics and to do what is right for all the people of America. Resist the impulse to add to the financial burden of the middle class and the poor. This is a moral issue. It's a matter of economic justice. We have never been more in need of heroes among our congresspeople. Be our hero.
Hello, I'm Andrew Johnson with Rebuild the American Dream. We keep hearing the phrase that we're broke and we can't afford things. If we stop the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan and incursions in other parts of the world, we'll have plenty of money. If we stop putting the burdens on the poor and the middle class and tax the rich, we'll have plenty of money. Do you hear that, Super Committee?
My name is Angela Mogan, and I'm a lawyer, and I believe that announcing that the Republicans on the Super Committee are going to vote in a block is an abrogation of their responsibilities to the United States citizens. They promise to do their best not to be partisan totally. Please, these issues are way too important for partisan politics. It's not about who wins the election. It's about how this country survives.
I'm Joel Weddington. I have something very simple to say. We are in survival mode. The U.S. is in survival mode. We're turning into a third world country. Unless we get fair taxation and stop the budget cuts, we're going down, and we are going to hold you accountable. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Jan Ireland. Listen up, I'm one of the 99%, and I want you to hear me. Dishonest people will tell you that Social Security has no money, that it's bankrupt, and they want to dismantle it. Honest people will tell you that we have $2.7 trillion in the Social Security Trust. The problem is, while baby boomers were busy working and paying all this extra money in, the government saw the extra funds and took it to the tune of $2.7 trillion, which is part of the $14-plus trillion debt. We owe China $1.6 trillion, but the single most entity that we owe the most money to is the Social Security Trust. We owe them $2.7 trillion, and I'm hoping for interest. So when you hear dishonest people say that Social Security is broken, that baby boomers are breaking the system, and that we need to dismantle it, honest people should say to them, well, when are we going to pay the Social Security back, the $2.7 trillion that we owe them? This is America. This is not Iraq. This is not Libya. We don't have Saddam Hussein and Gaddafi raiding the public coffers. We have honest people, I hope, in Congress who are going to start telling us when they're going to pay that money back. And for those of you who want to think about privatizing Social Security, I have one word for you: Enron.
My name's Terry Chin. Listen up, Super Committee. I manage a community center that provides vital emergency and social services to low-income members of our community. Our country cannot balance our budget on the backs of the poor, the elderly, and the disabled in our community. We have older adults earning less than $900 a month who rely on our lunch program for their main meal of the day. We see workers who are no longer able to provide for their families because they are now unemployed after years of steady work. We see women who have been victims of domestic violence who are struggling to make ends meet while trying to provide a safe place for their family. We need jobs, not cuts. And in the meantime, we need to be able to provide the safety net for our own community until our community members can get back on their own feet. Can you hear me now?
I'm Judith Brooks. I'm a real estate broker, and I've been a real estate broker for 30 years. And now it is heartbreaking to have to sell homes. Used to be fun, but now all I'm dealing with is people who are going through a grieving process. They're losing their homes, and now they're facing not only losing their home, but losing their credit rating, and through no fault of their own. They thought they had a nest egg, they had a property that they put money down, they had equity, and they've lost all that equity, plus they've lost the value in the home. So whether it's through job loss or downsizing or illness or whatever reason it is, they have found themselves in a situation where now they are in foreclosure. And it's heartbreaking. And plus, on top of all that, we do get offers, we get everything settled, and then the bank forecloses anyway. So everybody's out of luck.
So I'm Sasha Randall, and every one of these people behind me has silenced my voice. But I'm 23, and I fought to get here, and my voice will not be silenced anymore. We are the 99%. They capture all of us. They capture every single one of us. You would not know that, but you deserve to know that. You need to know that. And so we will tell you, and we will not stop until you hear every voice, because each one matters, and each story is important. Can you hear me now?
My name is George Scott Weichert. I'm an engineer living in Palo Alto. And I'm really mad that you're focused so much on non-defense domestic cuts. There are two things we can do that will completely solve our deficit and debt problem. Number one, listen to the CBO report on inequality. That all the economic growth has gone to the rich. We need to restore the top tax rate, and we need to add new tax brackets. Number two, the defense budget has grown 40% since 9/11. We can drop that defense budget back down to where it was before, the same way we did with the Vietnam War and Reagan's Cold War buildup. Those two will solve the problem.